अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ मिस रबिया एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक द बिगनिंग्स ऑफ द मुगल एम्पायर। सो द ओरिजिन ऑफ द मुगल एम्पायर, द मुगल डिसेंडेड फ्रॉम द मंगोल एंड तुर्किक पीपल्स ऑफ सेंट्रल एशिया। दे वर वॉरियर पीपल हु क्लेम्ड डिसेंट फ्रॉम बोथ चंगेज खान एंड तैमूर। Zahiruddin Babur was the founder of Mughal Empire and first emperor of the Mughal dynasty in the Indian subcontinent. He was a descendant of both Timur and Genghis Khan. Zahiruddin Babur was a young warrior king who inherited the throne of small kingdom of Ferghana in 1495 at the age of 12. Military tactics. Babur established contacts with the great neighboring empire of Safavids in Persia and the Ottoman in Turkey. He took control of the city of Lahore and then challenged the ruler of Delhi, Sultan Ibrahim Lodi. And in 1526, Babur's army met Lodi's in the Battle of Panipat. And Ibrahim Lodi was defeated in that battle and killed, and Babur took the throne of Delhi. The second Mughal emperor after the Babur, he was the Babur's eldest son Humayun. His great threat came from Sher Shah Suri, who had been an ordinary soldier Farid Khan and then a commander forces in the state of Bihar. Humayun basically was the second emperor of the Mughal Empire, who ruled over territory in what is now Afghanistan, Pakistan, Northern India and Bangladesh. Like his father, he lost his kingdom early but regained it with the aid of the Safavid dynasty of Persia with additional territory. Sher Shah Suri chased Humayun out of India altogether and set himself and his family as ruler in Delhi for the next 15 years. His big achievement was the building of Grand Turk Road from the Bengal to Punjab across the Indus River. Humayun retook Kabul, and when Sher Shah Suri became weak, he decided to reconquer his lost empire. As I already told you, he lost his kingdom early but regained it with the aid of Safavid dynasty of Persia and with additional territory as well. The Battle of Sirhind in June 1555 was a decisive victory of Mughal Empire. At the time of his death, the Mughal Empire spanned almost 1 million square kilometers. The reign of Akbar the Great. Under the reign of Akbar, more territories came under Mughal control, including northern India, Rajputana, Gujarat, and Bengal. A strong personality and successful general, Akbar gradually enlarged the Mughal Empire to include much of Indian subcontinent. His power and influence, however, extended over the entire subcontinent because of Mughal military, political, cultural, and economic dominance. In the later decade of his reign, Akbar restored his control over Kabul, and the whole region came under central Mughal authority. Mughal government and religion under Akbar. Akbar was very concerned about the fairness and justice of his rule over the Mughal Empire. He was determined that the local people should be well treated, and for this reason he changed some of the taxation policies that had previously been in use. To preserve peace and order in a religiously and culturally diverse empire, he adopted policies that won him the support of his non-Muslim subjects. Most of the non-Muslim support Akbar a lot. Non-Muslim did not have to pay the special tax, and there were to be no payment taken from pilgrim going to Hindu shrines. And he became the follower of Sufi Salim Chishti, and he went to ask for a special prayer for the sun. Significant building. He made a lot of big buildings in his empire. One of his key buildings was Diwan-e-Khas, or the Hall of Private Audience. In its center was a pillar open to all at the base, on top of which was a platform connected to the edges by bridges. Akbar sat in the center, and his discussion could be overheard by people listening silently below. Akbar laid the foundation of Lahore Fort and the Agra Fort, which was rebuilt by his successor as well. They show how the wealth of empire was used to build dazzling structures that were secure forts as well as grand places. So this was our chapter, and here are the question answers of these chapters.